Welcome back to Fox 8 News in the Morning. NASA is about to usher in a new era of human spaceflight. This afternoon, American astronauts will once again travel on an American rocket from American soil to the International Space Station. It is the first time since the end of the space shuttle program back in 2011. NASA astronaut Tracy Caldwell Dyson joins us now to talk about this historic and exciting launch. Tracy, first of all, good morning.
Good morning, Wayne. Great to be here.
Great to have you. Hey, talk about the importance of today's launch. Why is this one so special?
Well, every launch is special, but today ushers in a new era of space flight. It's a giant leap for our private industry, as well as the beginning of a test flight season for NASA.
Well, let's talk about how this particular launch with SpaceX is going to be different than the other ones that NASA had total control over.
Well, SpaceX built everything, and they're controlling everything with NASA oversight, and they had to meet requirements, and they've got, of course, our NASA astronauts on board, and so it's their show, they're going to prove their capability today.
Talk about the capsule. I keep hearing things about this capsule.
The Dragon capsule. It's called Crew Dragon, and right now we've got two astronauts on board, but I believe it seats four, so we're hoping to increase our crew size with those to carry it to the space station and ferry astronauts back and forth.
It's a reusable capsule, I understand.
That's what I understand as well.
Talk about what they're going to be doing when they get to the space station. What's their assignment?
Well, their assignment is mainly this test mission, and it's an end-to-end test. They're going to, once they're docked to the space station, they'll become a space station crew member. And with that comes all sorts of work in terms of science and maintenance. There might be some spacewalks, some robotic arm operations. But their main duty is to test flight the Crew Dragon.
Because of the pandemic, NASA is advising people not to come down to Cape Canaveral to actually see this launch. What are the other options that you've heard of?
Oh, well, you can tune in live to NASA TV. Coverage begins about a quarter after noon, Eastern time. And otherwise, you've got YouTube, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, Twitch, LinkedIn. There's all sorts of social media platforms where you can stay connected.
Excellent. What's the future of space travel now that we have started once again?
Well, we are going to continue our flights to the International Space Station, and then we hope to begin our flights in the Artemis program on board Orion and SLS, and we begin our journey to the moon and to Mars.
All right. Astronaut Tracy Caldwell Dyson, thank you very much for your time this morning.
My pleasure, Wayne. Thank you.
All right. By the way, the launch is set for 4:33 this afternoon. Thank you.